Welcome there, everyone. Today I'm going to show you a little trick that I've been practicing for custom grooving my tires on the compact front-wheel drive cars. Now, I just picked up a brand new tool from Harbor Freight that is fantastic. It's been doing a great job so far on custom grooving these tires. So I'm going to show you guys the tool I bought and show you the method that I've been doing to groove out these wheels. Now, I did try this once in the past before on my Cutlass car on one of the front-wheel drive tires. Probably can't see it too well because it's kind of dark, but you can see I just put a slice across the tread pattern on the tire itself. Didn't actually groove it out, I just took my metal cutting wheel and just cut a slice of the tread right off the top. Now just doing that little bit made a huge difference on that car, because I could take that car and put it in my backyard on grass. I would mash the pedal all the way to the floor and the tires would spin to take off. Well, after I parked the car and looked at the ground, I could see two tire marks in the grass. And you could tell the difference between which tire had the extra grooves and which one did not, because the one that was just a street tire was spinning in the grass, and it had made marks on my yard as I mashed on the gas. The other side actually gripped the grass and pulled the car forward. So, I'm going to be actually doing better grooves to my new tires, and these are going to go on the front of this Lincoln here, the 1991 Lincoln Continental. Here is one tire complete, just to show you what the aftermath looks like when I get the other one done. As you can see, I went and did every other chunk of the tire on the outside pattern. I just followed the pre-existing rain channels that are grooved in these. I did it on both sides here. And I left the middle of the tire completely stock. I do think it's going to make a difference, but I won't know until I get it on the car and actually test it out. There's tons of different patterns you can do. I mean, teach their own on what method they think works best for their wheels. Our rules, since this is a stock class, by the way, a lot of people are probably like, oh, just buy mud tires and stuff. We have to use basic street tires on our cars. We cannot double them. No protectors, no flaps, extra sidewall flaps on them. All I do to my tires is put a tube in them, and then I'm going to custom groove them this year and see if it makes a difference. So here you can see I've started on this tire, and there's the rain channels I talked about. I cut in the chunks out, so this one's going to stay. This chunk will get cut out, that chunk will get cut out, that chunk there. So I'm going to do a few just to show you how I'm cutting these with the tool here. Oh, by the way, this is the new tool. Got this from Harbor Freight while it was on sale. This is known as an oscillating multi-tool is the correct name for it. Kind of a funky name. I've never even heard of these before, didn't they? They existed. They've been around for years. And all it is a bit here. This bit vibrates back and forth very fast. And they have a whole bunch of different attachments you can buy for them. You can do little solves blade type styles if you're cutting through wood, PVC pipe, plastic, whatever. This is a wedge design with a sharpened bit on the end, the blade there. This blade was actually made, I think, for pulling up linoleum, carpet, things like that. You can get ones for removing the mortar in between cinder blocks and bricks, for drywall, all kinds of crazy stuff, sanding. Yes, that was only $20 on sale at Harbor Freight, worth every dollar. Fantastic to get that. It does not come with blades. Make sure you go and get one of them on the separate. Here's the box it came in. Just show you what it looks like. There's the name of it. And I mean, there's tons of different functions you can do with this thing. Really cool thing. It obviously was not meant for grooving tires, but it works fantastic for doing that. I saw a video on YouTube of some guy doing it for his mud truck, so I thought I'd give it a try. But all right, that's enough talk. Let's go ahead and get to the action. Show you guys how I'm cutting these off. So as you guys can see there, that was very fast, very easy. Best part about this is there's hardly any smoke at all, just very little. There's no rubber dust. I've tried using a Sawzall before. I've tried using a metal cutting blade, you know, for the disc blades for cutting grooving tires, and that is just a mess. You get smoke and rubber dust everywhere in the room. It's hard to breathe, bad on your eyes. I mean, you can see here, I started doing one of these tires with a cutting wheel here, grinder, and it was just blowing chunks of rubber all over outside. Not the best method. This is just fantastic. It goes super fast. And also, once you start using this, the longer you do it, the faster it goes. Because the blade itself, the friction between the blade and the rubber, it starts heating up the blade. And it gets very hot to where it actually melts and cuts the rubber at the same time. So by the time I did the first one, it was kind of a little bit slower cut. The second one was heating up, and as you saw the third one there, it was cutting a lot faster because the blade was hot by that point. Now this tool does get very warm up here on the front, and to risk overheating this tool and killing it, because obviously it was a $20 tool, don't want to kill it, it probably isn't the best made. I only do maybe half a way around a tire at a time, which is about anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes. Once you get the hang of it, you can go really quick on it. Then I'll let the tool cool down for maybe an hour or so, and I'll come back to the other half. I just kind of tinker with this on the side or a rainy day, whenever. Either way, very easy to do. As you saw there, I was just zipping through this. You got to kind of learn your own method. Every tire is going to require a different cutting method. And these tires, by the way, do have air in them. They're still aired up on the rims. It does not heat the rubber up much where it's going to blow up the tire. Nothing bad there. You just got to have two hands on the tool and try to hold it for the vibration. And the quick method on the tip for the way I was cutting these, obviously you cannot come in, you can't go flat with the blade and cut straight across because your blade is too wide. It'll cut into both the side rubber sections plus the center one you want to remove. So what I do here is I actually take my blade, I put the corner of the blade in the existing rain channel, and I kick my blade on an angle, and I go like that, and it takes off half the chunk I want to remove. Then I put the other corner of the blade in this rain channel, and I kick the blade on an angle. So then I slide it up and remove that half. Almost where, see this current crack line there? I do this half at one time, then come back and do this half, both angles. Then I'll come through and turn my tool sideways in here, and I'll cut down vertical a little bit into depth, then slowly flatten it out as I cut across. That's the way it cuts off that center hump. Then you just come in the back corner here, make a slice, and pull off the chunks. Even if you don't get it all, usually the rubber is pretty weak and you can grab it with your finger and rip it the rest of the way off. So there you have it, guys. Really cool method. Works fantastic for cutting off chunks of tires. These tires here, the sidewalls were starting to get dry rotted on them, and the tread had maybe 30 to 40% left. You can go to junkyards, tire shops, find a tire that had a nail hole in it. Find one that has rotten sidewalls on them. You can put tubes in them. Nail holes don't matter. Drywall, side rotten things, it don't matter if you put a tube in them. Still going to hold air for a derby use, for one derby. Just find something that has a little bit of tread left, and you can cut any pattern you want for any type of derby. So give it a try, guys. If you come up with any really cool designs, let me know. If you experiment, let me know what method works best for cutting designs and tires, what seems to give the best traction, and so on. Also, let me know if you would use this on a front-wheel drive car only, or do you guys think this method would work for a rear-wheel drive car? Some of you guys that run stock class with the full-size cars, this could also work on those tires. All right, guys, I'm going to get back to work on these wheels. Stay tuned for another update. This Lincoln's getting closer to being done.